Hello and welcome all of you. My name is Bhupendra and today in this video, I am going to discuss about the group by function, which is a part of ITER Tools module. As you all know, ITER Tools module is one of the most popular built-in module of the Python, which comes with the Python package already. In order to use this module, you just have to import this and you can use the functions which are defined inside that module. So as you can see on your screen that in order to use the group by function, I have to import the group by function from the ITER Tools module. So how we can import that? From ITER Tools import group by. So by writing this code, I'm trying to import this group by function from where? From the ITER Tools module. Okay. So now let's run this and we can verify that by taking help on group by. So as you can see here, it is giving me the pop-up. It means this group by function is loaded in my this current notebook. So before I move on with the group by function, let me give you a little definition about the group by function. As you can see, what it returns the consecutive keys and groups from the iterable. Okay. So if the key function is not specified or is none, the key defaults to an identity function and returns the element unchanged. So let me make it simple. So before I describe this definition again, let me ask you a question. My question is, I have this list. Okay, I have this list. I want to group my elements with the key and the groups related to that particular key. For example, I have a lot of number here in this list. I have 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, 9. I want to group my numbers according to the keys. Let's say I have 1 and how many ones I have for 1. I want to place all the ones to that particular key. This is what we have to do in this question. So how we can do this? There are many ways. Before I solve this, let me tell you guys, there are many ways you can solve this problem. But my objective is to use the group by function. How we can solve this using group by, okay? So group by function returns the consecutive keys. So keys should be consecutive in your input list also, okay? Input iterable, whatever the iterable is, the input value should be consecutive. Means if one is there and if one is here, so all ones should come at one place. So this is possible only if we sort our list and we have sorted function. Okay, we can sort our list using ml.sort also. ml.sort, this is a list method. As you know, ml.sort will change the original list and it will sort our ML in an ascending order. So after this, you can verify that we have sorted our list. As you can see here, we have 111, 222, then 333. So all numbers are now arranged in ascending order. Now we can perform group by on this consecutive number. And what you have to do is just use the group by function and pass this ML, the sorted ML. And let's see what we are getting. Okay, we are getting a group by object which is living at this particular address. So let's see what is inside this group by object. So I can pass this object to the list function. So list function will consume this object. Whatever the thing is present inside this group by object, we can see that by passing this to a list. So list will consume this object and it will display all the values which are present inside the group by object. So let's run this. See, this is what we have inside that list. I have these groups 1, 2, 3. These are the key names and we are getting some objects here again inside the tuple. So as you can see here, inside a tuple I have two values. One is the key name and one is the object. What is inside that object, we don't know. So let's iterate over our object and let's see what we are getting here. So what I have to do is, let's store this group by to an object x, group by of ml. I have stored this in x. Now I can iterate over my object x for I in x. Okay, print I. So this is what I'm getting. See, in I am getting tuple and inside tuple I have two values. One is the key name and second one is the object itself. So I can pass two variables here to receive these two values from the tuple. So I will now have the key name only and J will have the object. So if I print I only, I will get the key names 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the numbers which are present in this ML. Okay, I have not used J here. Now let's use list of J. As you know, J is the object again. So what is inside this object? We can see it clearly by passing this object to the list function. So list function will consume this J object, and whatever the thing is present inside the J, we will be able to see that when we pass this to the list. And see, this is what we have inside that object. Now it is so good. See, we are able to group our numbers to their respective keys so easily with the group by function. So this is how group by is working. But make sure that group by function takes consecutive numbers, because it looks for consecutive numbers. If 1, 1, 1, 1 is coming, it will group all the incoming ones to a particular key called 1. Then after 1, if 2 is coming consecutively, it will create a key called 2, and it will place all the 2s to that particular key. So in between, if it gets any other number, let's say 3, so it will create another key 3, and for 3 it will keep that all the incoming 3s to that key. Okay, so the number should be consecutive. If it is in unordered fashion, the group will be in unordered fashion, and I will show you that here. Okay, let me show you this example again. What happens if the numbers are not in the consecutive manner? Let me paste this, and now I won't short my ML. Okay, so this is the input list which I am going to use, and let's use the group by function without using shorting our list. Okay, and let's see and see what we are getting. So this is not what we want. Okay, so I hope you understood what is the problem here, because the numbers are not in the consecutive function. So whichever number is coming, group by function is creating the key name, and it is placing that number to that particular key. Okay, so this is not what we want. It means we have to short our list. Okay, let's understand this with another problem. Here, as you can see, I have this list of tuples, and inside tuples I have two values. One is a string, second one is the number itself. I want to group my tuples according to the alphabet. For example, these three tuples belong to one group, that is A. So I want to create a key called A, and for that key I will have these tuples. Okay, and I want to create another key called B, and for B I have two values. Yani we have two groups for that. Okay, so how we can do this? Let's create it directly for I comma J in group by. I want to group by my ML. Since you can see here the data is in the sorted order. Okay, I want to order it according to A, and we have A A A, and after that I have B B B. So there is no problem here. Okay, so no need to short our ML. What I have to do is just write it like this, and then print I comma list of J. Okay, because J will be the object again. So in order to see what is inside that object, I have to pass this object to the list function. Now let's see. So this is what we are getting. We are getting correct output, but this is not the format which we want. The problem here is, see, I am not specifying the key name, and that was it was telling in the definition. See what it was telling: the group by function has the key function there. Okay, if we don't specify any key function there, it takes it by default as none. Okay, that is what here it was happening. Okay, we were not specifying key, so it was taking it as a none value. But now we have a tuple, and inside that tuple we have a string as well as numbers. So here we need to specify that the group by function should group our data along which number, along the alphabets or along the numbers. So I need to specify here. So how we can specify? We can use the key parameter here. Okay, so I need to use the inbuilt key. See, by default it is none. So if I write it none again, the value will be unaffected. We are getting the same result here again. But in place of none, I can use the anonymous function called lambda. Okay, so here we are seeing a very good use of lambda function again. So I want to group my list according to alphabet. So in every tuple we have our alphabets at index 0. As you can see here, A is at index 0, here B is at index 0, here again A is at index 0 of this tuple. So what I am doing is, group by function is passing this tuple to the lambda function x, And from that x, yani from that tuple, I want index 0. It means I want to group by my elements according to the element which is at index 0. Okay. Now it will work properly. And see, this is what I wanted. Okay. So for a key, for key A, I have all these values. Okay. For key B, I have all these values. Okay. So this is how group by function is working. Now, here you can see the tuples are not in the ordered format. Here we have A1, A3, then again we have B4, then A2, B5. So what will happen here? Let me copy this and see. If I do this again here, we will be able to create groups, but we will have extra groups here, A, B, A, B again. Why this is happening? Because the elements are not in the consecutive function. This A2 should be before this tuple B4. Okay. So in such problems, what I need to do is I need to sort my ML. So I can use the sorted function here. ML equals to sorted. And what I want to sort? I want to sort my ML according to which value I need to pass the key here. Okay. In sorted is again an inbuilt function. Okay, guys. I hope you understand this. I have already discussed about this function in my previous some videos. Okay. So I'm assuming that you already know this. So key is a parameter which is also which can also be used for sorted function. Okay. Key. How I want to sort my list? I need to mention that I want to sort my list according to the value at index 0 in the tuples. That is this, okay? And then I want to use this ML. Now see, before sorting, we were getting this output. Now I have sorted my ML and I have stored that in the ML again. Now I am working on sorted data. See, now we are getting proper output. So it is now very clear that group by function works on consecutive data. So the data which is coming from the list or from any iterable, it should be in a sorted order. Okay, so it will be able to group it properly. Okay, now we have again another problem here. You can see here I have some records of a student, so student marks and student grades. So inside a list, now I have a dictionary. Okay, so let's say I want to group the student marks according to their grades. And here you can see the grade A is here, then here we have grade A, here we have grade A, then somewhere here grade B. So what I want to group them according to grades. So grade A dictionary will be here, grade B will be here, grade C will be here. So how we can do this? Let's iterate over this and let's group by this. But before grouping, I have to order our dictionary. Okay, how we can order this? We can use the sorted function again. Okay, so s sorted equals to sorted, and what I want to sort, I want to sort my students' data. And how I want to sort, I can mention it in the key parameter. Okay, so key equals to lambda x, okay, comma. What? So in X, I am getting this dictionary, okay? And inside that dictionary, I want to sort my data according to grade, okay? So X is the dictionary, and from the dictionary, I want this grade key, okay? I want to sort my data. And now let's first see what we have got in sorted, as sorted. Okay, what is the problem here? Marks is colon 75, invalid syntax is giving. Okay, I have missed the comma here. Now it is in proper format. See, I have S sorted data here. It is properly sorted, grade A, then grade B, then grade C. What was here? You can clearly see. Now this data is ready to be grouped. So what I have to do is for I comma j, j will have the group name, I will have the key name. Okay, for I comma j in group by, and how I want to group by the data as sorted comma. Now I need to pass the function to the key parameter, and the function would be lambda x, according to which key I want to sort my data. I want to group my data, the key grade, okay, because x is the dictionary, and in that dictionary I want to group by my data using the grade key. Okay, now colon, then print I comma j, and list of j. See, this is what I wanted. This is correct, right? I have key called A, and for A I have all these value grouped for the key A. So it is now so easy to get the value for A grade, for B grade, for C grade. So this is a short data. Maybe you can say I can solve this using some other trick, but this group by function is doing your work in much more easier way. So this is how we use group by, and that's it about this video. I hope you understood it, and if you like this video, you can comment down below, you can like this video, and you can share this video to all your friends, whoever needs this kind of video. I regularly and from time to time I upload such type of conceptual video on my channel. So stay tuned and keep clicking. Till then, take care. Bye bye.